Lord children, when our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ was born in Bethlehem 2000 years ago, three wise men from the east came to worship him. They brought him gold, myrrh, and frankincense that were the best gifts they could give to the king. What can we give? He needs our hearts. We can give our hearts to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Now we'll continue with Unit 19, Theories of Evolution. Life had evolved along with evolution of Earth towards the end of 18th century. Evolution is the gradual change occurring in living organisms over a period of time. Formation of new species due to changes in specific characters over several generations as response to natural selection is called evolution. The natural changes occurring is explained through the theories of evolution as proposed by Lamarck and Darwin. Lamarckism. Jean-Baptiste Lamarck, 1944 to 1829, was a French naturalist well known for his theory of evolution. Lamarck's theory of evolution was published in Philosophic Zoologique in the year 1809. It is popularly known as theory of inheritance of acquired characters or use and disuse theory or Lamarckism. Principles of Lamarckism. Number one, internal vital force. Living organisms or their component parts tend to increase in size continuously. This increase in size is due to the inherent ability of the organisms. Environment and new needs. A change in the environment brings about changes in the need of the organisms. In response to the changing environment, the organisms develop certain adaptive characters. The adaptations of the organisms may be in the form of development of new parts of the body. Use and disuse theory. Lamarck's use and disuse theory states that if an organ is used constantly, the organ develops well and gets strengthened. When an organ is not used for a long time, it gradually degenerates. The ancestors of giraffe were provided with short neck and short forelimbs. Due to shortage of grass, they were forced to feed on leaves from trees. The continuous stretching of their neck and forelimbs resulted in the development of long neck and long forelimbs, which is an example for constant use of an organ. The degenerated wing of kiwi is an example for organ of disuse. Theory of inheritance of acquired characters. When there is a change in the environment, the animals respond to the change. They develop adaptive structures. The characters developed by the animals during their lifetime in response to the environmental changes are called acquired characters. According to Lamarck, the acquired characters are transmitted to the offspring by the process of inheritance. Flowchart showing the postulates of Lamarckism. Environmental change, need for new structure, development of new structure, gives rise to organs of use and organs of disuse. Organs of use, inheritance of adaptive characters, origin of new species. Organs of disuse, degeneration of the structure. The next topic is Darwinism or theory of natural selection. Charles Darwin from 1809 to 1882 was one of the great naturalists and philosopher of 18th century. He was born in England in 1809. While studying in college, through his friendship with Professor J.S. Henslow, he was fascinated towards nature. At that time, the British admirably planned a voyage of exploration for 5 years on a ship called HMS Beagle around South America. Dr. Henslow was asked to nominate a young naturalist for the voyage. Darwin was given the opportunity. During his 5 years, 1831 to 1835 voyage, he visited many parts of the world, a number of islands including the Galapagos Island and Pacific Island. Darwin made elaborate observations on nature of the land, plants and animals of the regions he visited. He further worked for a period of 20 years to develop the theory of natural selection. Darwin published his observations and conclusions under the name Origin of Species in 1859. The Book of Darwin demonstrates the fact of evolution. It elaborates on the theory of natural selection for evolutionary transformation. Now we'll learn the principles of Darwinism, that is overproduction, struggle for existence, variations, survival of the fittest or natural selection, and origin of species. The first one is overproduction. Living beings have the ability to reproduce more individuals and form their own progeny. They have the capacity to multiply in a geometrical manner. This will increase reproductive potential, leading to overproduction. The second one is struggle for existence. Due to overproduction, a geometric ratio of increase in population occurs. The space to live and food available for the organisms remain the same. This creates an intense competition among the organisms for food and space, leading to struggle. The struggle for existence are of three types. Number one, intra-specific struggle. Competition among the individuals of same species. Inter-specific struggle. Competition between the organisms of different species living together. C. Environmental struggle. Natural conditions like extreme heat or cold, drought, and floods can affect the existence of organisms. Third principle is variations. The occurrence of variation is a characteristic feature of all plants and animals. Small variations are important for evolution. According to Darwin, favorable variations are useful to the organism and unfavorable variations are harmful or useless to the organism. The fourth one is survival of the fittest or natural selection. During the struggle for existence, the organisms which can overcome the challenging situation survive and adapt to the surrounding environment. Organisms which are unable to face the challenges are unfit to survive and disappear. The process of selection of organisms with favorable variation is called as natural selection. Origin of species. According to Darwin, new species originates by the gradual accumulation of favorable variations for a number of generations. The next topic is variation. Sexual reproduction, which involves meiosis, helps in recombination of genes during gametic fusion. This leads to differences in the phenotype of the offspring from its parents. These differences are called variation. Variation is the difference found among individuals of the same species and the offspring of the same parent. Variation is the raw material which plays an important role in evolution. Evolution would not be possible without variation. Types of variations are somatic variation and germinal variation. Somatic variation. These are the variations which affect the body, that is the somatic cells of the organisms. They are not heritable. They occur due to environmental factors. Germinal variation. These variations are produced in germ cells of an organism. They are inherited. They may be present in ancestors or may occur suddenly. They are classified into two types, continuous variation and discontinuous variation. Continuous variation. These are small variations which occur among individuals of a population. They are also called as fluctuating variations. They occur by gradual accumulation in a population. Example, skin color, height and weight of an individual, color of eye, etc. Discontinuous variation. These are sudden changes which occur in an organism due to mutations. They do not have any intermediate forms. These large variations are not useful for evolution. Example, short-legged Ancon sheep, six or more digits, that is fingers in human, etc. Discontinuous variation formed the basis for mutation theory proposed by D. Rice. Thank you, children. Learn your lessons well. Bye.